great slice from Wilander. That's something that he added to his game in 1988, the year he won 3 of 4 Grand Slams. Mats Wilander was a slice backhand, and for a two-hander, he hits it as well as anyone.
Now, Lendl had beaten him in the French and the Open final in 87, so Wilander obviously knew that he needed to improve something, and that was it.
Yes. Game point.
Talking about a great slice, and he hits a horrible one floating well long.
Maybe not as consistent as years past, but this is a big point right now at 4-2. And he went big there.
Ooh, that was tight call. Second serve, game point for both in the no-ad scoring system.
Oh. Set it up perfectly,
it's
but
five-two.
5-2 Wilander.
When we return, the stunning conclusion to Lendl's comeback.
And knowing that he has broken me before twice, so obviously I need to reverse the trend. Not thinking ahead, thinking at that game.
This show is brought to you by Caesars Atlantic City, the life you were meant to live. Harrah's Resort Atlantic City, where everybody plays a part. And Yvonne Lendl's Champions Academy, where greatness happens.
See if Lendl can get back in this match here. He needs a break.
Love the team.
Well, good start for Lendl here. Oh, beautiful point.
Well-constructed point from Lendl. Was able to fight off a tough body serve.
Luck 30.
And eventually got control with his forehand.
How much what does that will to win come back, even at 50 years old?
If you know Yvonne, it's there. He wants to win.
Yeah.
When he does something, he wants to do it well. So he's going to be fighting for every point till this thing is over. He's got a little bit of a chance to break here at 15-30.
Another great point, Wilander to the net.
Wilander's hitting the ball, if anything, bigger than he hit it in the 80s, a couple of these shots. That was two well-ripped ground strokes.
Ah. 30-40.
All right, Lendl with a chance now for his first break. And there it is. You knew he wouldn't go easy, Jimmy.
Gets one break back. He still has a little bit of work to do to get back in this set.
Another well-constructed point there, and a little help from the net. Sat up for him there. Fifteen love now.
Now, that's one of the problems with running around your backhand is you leave a little bit of court open. Wilander saw it, sensed it and hit a beautiful slice down the line to set up the winner.
Oh, what a big ace.
That wasn't an ace from power. That was placement. Wide slicing serve in the deuce court. Saw it again, running around his backhand, leaving a little bit of court open. Those are the old instincts from Lendl. He liked to hit forehands. He liked to stay in that backhand corner.
Oh.
30-40.
All right, Wilander now point away from the match.
Because of the scoring system, it's actually double match point. Even if he gets to deuce, the next point would win the game. So tough spot here for Lendl. He needs a couple of big serves.
Oh, he's going for it right there. Oh, pressure point, and Lendl staves off one match point.
Well, this is the third time on Lendl's serve that they've played this no ad point. Wilander's always picked the ad side, this time the deuce court.
And there it is, these two great rivals meeting once again, and Wilander wins it 6-3.
Great to see Ivan Lendl back on a tennis court.
What was it like playing Ivan again? In a way, I think I played pretty good, Ivan played great. The first thing he said after the match, he said, next time I will be better.
So what did it feel like? It's been 16 years since you've been back on the court.
Well, it was great. It was great playing again, and as you can see, my back is not hurting, so which is nice, and I enjoyed it. I would have enjoyed playing a bit better more, but as I said, the first, second, third time will be hard, and then it's going to get better.
Would you guys want to have him back?
For the commemorative Steuben Glass Trophies, please welcome the Vice President of Marketing for Caesars Atlantic City, Aaron Chamberlain.
I really believe that he was the guy that every male and every female tennis player looked at and said, if I want to be the best in the world, I got to do what he does.
You know, you need the whole package. You need to have the game, you need the heart, and you need the mind. You know, Ivan had it. You know, he had the great game. His heart was strong, mentally he was strong.
The world, you know, loved Ivan for his greatness. I think in this second time around, people are going to get to know Ivan as a person.
I've always been a tennis fan, but before a tennis player. So to come here and be able to participate in an event with guys like Lendl, and you know, it's cool for me.
He was legendary for his mental strength and his fitness level. It definitely changed men's tennis.
While the Caesars event is just the beginning, Ivan's time in Atlantic City has already been an inspiration.
It's always nice when people appreciate you, and people were really looking forward to seeing good tennis in Atlantic City. I think they were genuinely excited about it. It was fun playing with Mats, and brought back a lot of memories. I would like to play more matches. I had fun.
The determination that brought Ivan Lendl to the peak of tennis is the driving force behind his return. The return of a champion.